This video analyzes the concept of information overload. So first of all, what is information overload? In this internet era, we have access to so much information which is making us feel overwhelmed. To define this situation, the term information overload was coined. So what are the causes of information overload? Until recently, most of the responsibility and the power of disseminating information was in the hands of traditional media, which means newspapers, books, radios, etc. But with the proliferation of internet and technology, now we have so many channels of information, such as blogs, social media, etc. So there is so much information, and hundreds of websites are created every day with the purpose of spreading information and to attract readers. So this is turning into information overload. And before the information age, traditional media channels used to send only the most important information because the resources and the ways of spreading information are limited. But now there are no such limitations. That's why we have so much news. Every little thing is now a news. Even if we watch news for 24 hours a day, there is something uncovered. And new branches of studies are created regularly to study the subjects in much a better way. For example, sociology is a relatively new branch. Even historical data is being revived to study the patterns. So these in-depth studies are creating lots and lots of information. Having information is a good thing, but too much information is causing some problems. Now let's see what are they. Due to the availability of so much information, it is very much difficult to focus on what is really needed. For example, children tend to get lost in the information when all they wanted is help with their homework. Too much information is often distracting. And some people will feel anxiety and confusion and stress because there is so much information and so little time. Often people feel that there is so much to learn and whatever they know is not enough, and thereby tend to develop psychological problems. If we take the example of students who are preparing for government exams, they often feel overwhelmed with the availability of too many books and other resources to study. In college, we can only focus on our books and all the questions comes from the syllabus. And if it is not, we can simply say that it is out of syllabus. But students who are preparing for government exams do not have the choice. So they feel like they should not take chances, and as there are so many resources available, one may fall into the trap of covering most of the resources and can end up forgetting everything. As so much information is consumed on a daily basis, our retention abilities are decreasing. Our capacity to store information in the memory is limited, and hence it's difficult to remember everything, especially if so much information is consumed. If we concentrate on so many resources, we cannot really focus. As a result, attention spans are decreasing. And it's very difficult to make decisions because of the availability of so many choices, like too many books and websites to choose from. To conclude this topic, we can say that information overload is not bad because availability of too much information is much better than the lack of information. The better approach to deal with information overload is to understand its effects on our minds and to choose a few resources for the time being and not looking back at the decision helps in mitigating the psychological impacts of information overload. So that's it about this topic. What are your thoughts on this topic? Tell us through the comment section, and thank you for watching.